Welcome to TradersArmy.com, defending your right to build wealth and preserve capital for generations to come.
Good morning, everybody, and welcome to today's edition of the Daily Market Commentary. I'm your host, Chuck Fulkerson. Everybody had an amazing trading day yesterday, as we had one of those days where the market moved into some of our zones, but then kind of just went meh into some of those zones. So we'll talk a little bit about it. If you're new to the channel, do me a favor, click the subscribe button down below so that you get the updates and the alerts as we put them out there. So let's go ahead and dive right in. So first of all, the S&P, we're down about 1 point this morning, fairly flat. And yesterday, our little supply level, price came into the supply level and we got a whole lot of just basically sideways price action, right? Not a whole lot of things occurred in there. And we had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 candles, which tells us it's probably not a whole lot of great movement out of that zone. So this level to me is no longer going to be one that I'm going to be leaning on or really even using at all. However, I will say the way that we're chopping around and basing means that above this level, I think we could get a decent breakout. You know, I think there's a chance for a breakout. If you're a little bit more aggressive, you could take it right about here, just above this level, for a breakout to the upside to allow price to continue to run. But remember what our six candle rule is designed to do. It's designed to minimize the exposure we have to trades that may not really work out in our favor for those longer term moves. In the Nasdaq, we didn't quite make it back to the supply level. Now, yesterday in the daily market commentary, I talked about this level inside the Nasdaq, which was this area right in here. And that level, actually, we got a nice little move away from. So if you took that level, leave me a comment below. Let me know, you know, how that trade worked out for you. I think that if you are more bearish today, the Nasdaq is your play. And the Nasdaq could be a play on, especially with this upper wick we just had here in our most recent candlestick, could be a play for a candle-to-candle opportunity as price coming down from that region. The Nasdaq down a little bit more this morning than the S&P from a percentage standpoint. Now, crude oil. If you look, we identified this level yesterday in crude. Price came into the level, and then we got a little bit of a move away. Remember, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Price hadn't really started to make a move after the sixth candle. Now, this isn't, you know, this is also, I'm going to pull this up here real quick. So one of the things that we do at Traders Army is we keep a private trade feed of the trades that we look at, both in the daily market commentary as well as in our live trade rooms. And this is what we put out in the trade feed. It was very simple that crude oil made a, from the area is running some overhead supply, so we're going to move our stop to break even. And that's exactly what we did. So moved our stop to break even, locked in the free trade. The ES made the short entry, stalled in the zone, and then we put the six candle rule in place. That was about 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Also at about 10:30, we talked about the GC level, working for a nice 2-to-1 for a little trade. So speaking of GC, that was our gold breakdown, as we got a little 2-to-1 move out of our gold breakdown before then reversing back up. So remembering that we take some profits at that 2-to-1 level, you know, I'm a huge believer in using that 2-to-1 area as an opportunity to take profits when they do show up, simply because, you know, it's great to say I trade 8-to-1 or 16-to-1 or 9-to-1, but in reality, if you take more of those 2-to-1s, it's amazing how many more opportunities you come up against with good trade areas. So your probabilities were probably so much better on that 2-to-1 that it's worth taking some off the table there quite often. Now, looking at this 4-hour chart, you know, I see that we're kind of chopping around, not a whole lot occurring. When I look at this on the 1 hour, we're definitely in a downward, you know, kind of trend, and I would need to see price breaking below here before I could get short again, right? We got to get below that area before I can take another short, which I think there you can. Next, taking a look at our bonds. In our bonds, we had looked at a little bit of a potential breakdown in bonds yesterday, off of one of these little levels. Got a little bit of a breakdown from there, but not a whole lot is occurring. I would actually look now to somewhere up in here for a potential reversal if price indeed makes its way back up into that range. Although not at super clean level, we do have this little area right in here. Not super clean, but it is a viable level. In the Aussie, we identified our supply. Price has not yet come back to our supply, as we did a lot of what I expected to do yesterday, a fairly tight range. Euro, very much the same thing, not back to our supply. And then the Canadian dollar, very much the same thing, as we're rallying close up. So none of our currency markets came really all that close to our level. So we're still waiting on those levels before we're going to, you know, do anything. And I'm a huge believer in trade your plan, right? You've got to trade your plan. And if price comes into your level, then make the trade. And if it doesn't, don't force it. There's no reason to force it. Looking at our level in the pound. Now, the pound we talked a little bit about yesterday, I'd put a little bit of a supply level. Price just blew right through that supply level. I mean, just absolutely blew right through it. And you're going to get those, obviously, from time to time. And then our confirmation entry, price blew through that confirmation entry to give us no entry. And then we got our sell-off here right soon after, right after that in the pound. And so now, once again, we are continued in our downward price action and downward price movement. This then becomes our next level of potential reversal in supply, is this area right through here. Okay, now, not a great time of day that this is formed. Actually, we got a little bit more, you know, better time of day is actually this area down in here. But we may see a little reversal back into this range, back into this area. Not a great time of day, so if you're a little bit more uncomfortable about it, you might want to make it a confirmation-style entry on this one. And then our Japanese yen trade, this is a confirmation entry. We switched it to a confirmation entry because we'd come close to it a couple of times, and that's why we do that, because price came in and did not get us filled. So now we remove that level, and we are coming up to a little wick over wick area here. And I'm a huge believer in these wick over wick zones. I find these wick over wick zones to be usually fairly effective for at least a little move out of that level. So keep an eye on that one for today. Early in the week, you know, my comment was that I really kind of believed that we would trade inside of the prior week's range. And that's kind of what we've done so far. We've got a holiday week coming up. So typically anytime there's a three-day holiday, there's a three-day holiday weekend coming up that we see minimal movement the week prior, and that's kind of what we're setting up for here. So just follow your rules. Don't force the trades. There's always going to be opportunities that show themselves. But if what happens is you feel like, oh, I missed out, then what you do is you wind up forcing trades. So just wait for things to come into your level, be patient, and it will get there. So tomorrow, no daily market commentary. We have the live trading room for TradersArmy.com subscribers. If you want to join, go to TradersArmy.com today and take a look and see if it makes sense for you to become a subscriber. Give it a try. If you like the way that we do things, we'd love to have you stay around. So, all right, everybody. Hope you have a great day. Talk to you soon.